Welcome everyone to this new series on SQL Server in this YouTube channel. My name is Shivam and today we are going to cover very important concept in SQL Server, which is stored procedures. So we will cover the following topics in this video. First, we will understand what are stored procedures. Then we will understand what permissions do a user require to create a stored procedure. We will also understand what syntax that we need to follow while creating a stored procedure, and we will also cover some examples. We will understand how we can create a stored procedure within other databases. We will understand what are parameters in a stored procedure, and we will also cover the topic how to create variables in a stored procedure. So let's get started. A stored procedure in SQL Server is a pre-compiled SQL code that is stored within a database. So we generally use stored procedures to combine multiple SQL queries that we need to execute multiple times. A simple example for a stored procedure can be when we require to insert multiple records in a table, we generally need to write the whole query. To shorten this purpose, we can create a stored procedure to insert queries so that we can pass the input as an input parameter, and after executing the procedure, the values are inserted to the table. Next, let's understand what permissions do we require as a user to create a stored procedure. So there are two permissions that a user require. First is a create procedure permission, and second is a alter on schema permission. So if we have a new user which do not have these permissions, so the user will not able to create the procedure. The SQL Server will return an error. Let's implement this in our SQL Server Management Studio. So you don't need to worry about the code. We have already created a detailed article on this, and the link of this article is available in the description box. So once you have opened the link from the description, you have to scroll down to the table of contents, click on show, and from here you can click on SQL Server create procedure permission, and it will open the topic in this section. So all the details regarding the permission is already explained in this article. We will copy this example from here and try to implement this in our SQL Server Management Studio. So let's have a new query. So in this example, we are granting the create procedure permission to SQL user, and we are also granting alter on schema permission to the same user. So let's execute it. So you can see the command has been executed successfully. Now we can use this user to create a procedure in SQL Server. Next, we will understand how we can create a stored procedure in SQL Server. So there are basically two options through which we can create stored procedure. First is the SQL Server Management Studio, and another is by using command line utilities. Now, a SQL Server Management Studio has an advantage over command line utility. By using SQL Server Management Studio, we will get a template that we can use to create a stored procedure. But for this, we need to understand the syntax. And same is the case with command line. In command line, we will not get any template. We need to write whole code from scratch, and we need to follow the syntax to create the procedure. So let's see what is the syntax to create a procedure in SQL. So the syntax for creating a stored procedure is as follows. First, we need to use create procedure command. Now there are two options. We can either use procedure, or we can use the short for procedure, which is PROC. After this, we need to specify the procedure name. Then we need to specify the as keyword. And after this, we will use the begin and end block to specify the body of the procedure. And in between comes the SQL queries. So this is the part of creating a procedure. So let's understand how we can create a procedure by implementing an example. So I'm moving to the post again. So I have moved to the article, and here we will copy the example to implement this. You can also do the same at your site. So here we have the topic, which is create procedure, SQL Server syntax. In this is the syntax that we have explained already. So we will move to the example. So this is the example. Let us copy this SQL Server Management Studio. In this example, I have used the create procedure command to create a procedure with the name get all records. After this, I have specified the as keyword, and then I have specified the body of the procedure by using begin and end block. In the body, I have used a simple SQL query to select three columns from a sample table. These three columns are ID, first name, and gender. And if we click on execute, the procedure will be created. Now, after the procedure has been created, if you are using SQL Server Management Studio, you have to move to the database in which you have created. After expanding the database, you have to expand programmability. And in this, we have a directory called stored procedures. Now, if you scroll down, the procedure with the same name is not visible. So first, we need to refresh this directory. Once the directory has been refreshed, the procedure will be visible. So after understanding the creation of a procedure, let's understand how we can execute it. So for this, we have the following syntax. First, we have to specify the exec keyword, which is short for execution. After this, we have to specify the name of the procedure. So let's understand this by executing our procedure, which I have created just now. So I'm removing this code. I will only add exec in the starting of the code, which is short for execution, and I will execute this code. After execution, so here we can see that we got three columns. First is ID, second is first name, and third is gender, and there are total 12 records in this table. Now let's move to the next topic. Next, we will understand how we can create a stored procedure in any database. So if you are using SQL Server Management Studio, you will get the option of selecting the database from the following list. This is the list of database. I am currently using the database with name SQL Server Guides. Now, what if you are using a command line utility? So I am back to the site. From table of contents, I will move to this topic, which is SQL Server create stored procedure in another database. So in this topic, we have explained how we can create a stored procedure in any other database. So first we need to use the use database command. After this we will write the body of the procedure. Here we need to specify the database name in place of database. So here is a small example. Let's execute it. So in this, first we have to specify the use database command. Here I am using SQL Server Guides database. After this, I am writing the code for the procedure, and I will click on execute. You can see now the code has been executed successfully. Now if we refresh our stored procedure directory, here we got the procedure. So let's move to the next topic. So the next topic is how we can create a stored procedure with parameters. So there are two types of parameters that we can have with a stored procedure. First is an input parameter, and second is an output parameter. An input parameter is basically used to send data from the client side to the procedure and use that data within the procedure. After this, we can also use output parameter. An output parameter is the reverse of input. It is used to send data from the procedure back to the client. So let's first understand how we can create an input parameter in a stored procedure. So this is the syntax that we can follow. First, we need to use the create procedure command to assign a name to our procedure. And after specifying the procedure name, we need to use the brackets. Within the brackets, we need to specify the parameter name and the data type. Now, here, a parameter name should start with @. It is important to specify @ symbol, because without it, it will not be possible to create a parameter. So let's implement a small example. Again, I have moved to the topic in the article. The detailed description regarding input parameter is already explained in this article. You can refer to this. In this, we will implement this example. So by using this procedure, we will pass a department name, and the procedure will return all the records of that particular department that we have passed. Let's copy this and execute it in our SQL Server Management Studio. So I've opened my Management Studio. Let's click on new query, paste the code. So in this procedure, I'm just using a select statement to select all the records where department name is the name that we have passed as an input. So let me execute this one. Procedure has been created successfully. After this, let's execute this procedure. So I will remove all this part. We'll put that. Now either we can specify the name, the input parameter directly, or we can specify the parameter for which we are assigning the value. So something like this. So both have the same meaning. I will remove this one and try to execute this result. So there are three, as I have passed legal as an input parameter, so the procedure searches for all the departments and return all the records which are there in the legal department. So there are three records. Now let's move to the next topic. After understanding the input parameter, let's understand what is output. So the syntax for input and output parameter is very much similar. For output parameter, we just need to specify output keyword. We can either specify output keyword or we can use out keyword as well. So for this, let's again execute an example. I'm moving back to the site. Here is the topic that we have already explained in detail. You can also read this. Here is a small example. So I've pasted this code in the Management Studio. Let's understand what is its use. So in this example, we are altering our get department records procedure. In this, first I have specified an input parameter of varchar with length 50, and after this I have specified another output parameter with name count. Now again I have used the same select statement to select the records of same department that we have passed as an input. After this I am using the set keyword to assign some value to our output parameter count. So for this I am using row count. So a row count is a system variable that returns the total number of rows affected by a previous query. So our previous query is this select statement. So if you remember, in our previous example there were three rows that were returned through this procedure for legal department. So let's execute this. So our procedure has been modified. Next, let's execute the procedure. So before executing the procedure, first we need to declare a variable that can hold the value returned by an output parameter. So I will copy this code. I will paste it here. So first we have created a variable named count of same type that we have used to define our output parameter. So both are of integer data type. After this I am executing the procedure, and for input parameter I have passed the legal as in the department name. After this, for the output parameter I have to pass this variable and specify it as an output. So the SQL server can understand that it needs to use the count variable to store the value of an output parameter. After this, we can use the select statement to select the value of the count. Now let's execute it. So here you can see the result. The procedure first returns three records from the legal department that are there in the department table. After this, we are using the select statement to select the value of a count. So the value which is there in the count is 3. I hope you get the point. Now let's move to the next topic. And our next topic is how we can create variables within a stored procedure. Let's first understand what is a variable. Variable in SQL Server is an object that we can use to store single values of some specific data type. For example, integer values, varchar of some specific length, bit values, etc. And we can use the following syntax to declare a variable within a stored procedure. First, we need to use the declare keyword. After this, we need to specify the variable name. Here also, we need to specify @. And after this, we need to specify the data type of that variable. So let's implement this with the help of an example. I move back to the site. This is the topic which we are covering, which is creating stored procedure with variables. Now we will implement this example. I will create a new query paste the code. Let's first understand what is use of it. So we are creating the procedure with name get employee list. In this example, first we have declared a variable of data type varchar max. After this, we are assigning an empty string to this variable. Then we are using the select statement, and in the select statement, you are using the variable to create a predefined string, and the string is used to represent the name of the employee and its corresponding department, and we are storing this string within our variable. In the last, we are printing out the string. If you go through this select statement, first we are assigning the variable an empty string first, then it will select the name from that department table, then we are concatenating a string which is an. After this, the select statement will select the department from the department table, and in the end we are using the char 10 to add a new line to the variable. In the last, we will printing it out using the print statement. So now you can see the command has been executed successfully. Now let's execute this procedure. So we will add exec for execution and then the name of that procedure, and we'll click on execute. So here is the result. The string is basically used to represent the department of that employee. So with this, we have come to an end of this video. If you like this video, do subscribe to our YouTube channel.